can fly. Good morning, YouTube. It's 11 o'clock, December 1st. Where has the year gone? It's ridiculous. I just woke up. Actually woke up at 5:30 this morning. I was on my phone. I was just... A lot happened last night. A lot. One being that I got let go from my serving and bartender job at Bootlegger. Yeah. Kind of a little bit my fault. And I should have done it in a more jokingly manner. But I didn't. I feel like it's honestly a blessing in disguise because I've been wanting to get out of the bar scene for a while, and I feel like it's a good thing. It just sucks that rent's due and I don't have any means of income right now other than the clothing line about to have the pop shop. I was going to use an analogy right there, but I didn't have anything. But I'm just going to take it as a blessing in disguise and just do that. So today, first things first, I have to go take care of some personal matters. Then after that, I need to eat breakfast. I need to work out. Have a photo shoot today, video photo shoot that you guys are coming with me. Then after that, it's just got a busy day. I've talked with a buddy at Best Buy about possibly working there. A girl that worked at Bootlegger talked to me about working at a telemarketing company, and I don't really know if I want to do that, but gotta have a job. So I've got messages coming through on my phone. I'm going to weigh out my options probably the rest of this week and then probably tackle it come Monday. I have to go talk to my landlord today about rent, and we're just going to take care of everything. So here we go. Get the day started. Let's go. Let's go, girl. Come on. Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. I see you. Might need this. There you go. Be good, girl. Be good. Okay. All recreate royalty stuff. Alright, so I just got to the gym. Well, I've actually been here for the past like 30 minutes. And I was doing arms, and in the middle of my arm workout, like last night when I was editing the video, my beats are jacked up. Sorry to change the subject real quick. But yeah, my beats are jacked up. But anyways, after editing my video last night, like I had to do the voiceover for the workout on my phone. So I got to send that file from my phone to my laptop to put on the video, then save the video, and then I gotta upload to YouTube. So that's what I'm about to do right now, mid-workout. Like, I just gotta get it done so I can upload this video. Haven't really recorded much. It is now 2:31 in the afternoon. Just been dealing with a lot of like personal stuff with, you know, my old job at Bootlegger, and had to go to the Attorney General's office, which nobody really ever wants to do that. But I had to get a record of what I paid for child support and my back Medicaid. And it's a little bit personal, but that's really what I've been doing, you guys. So you know, wouldn't really get that all on camera because it's nobody's business really, but I wanted to clue you guys in. That's why I haven't been recording, because I've been on the phone with just personal stuff. Trying to take care of some things with my paychecks and everything to see if my money was going where it should have went, and I don't, yeah, it's a long story. But anyways, I'm about to send this email real quick, get the video uploaded, and I'm going back to work now. So, yeah.
Everybody falls sometimes. Gotta find the strength to rise from the ashes and make a new beginning. Anyone can feel the ache. You think it's more than you can take, but you're stronger than you know. Don't you give up now, the sun will soon be shining. You gotta face the clouds to find the silver lining. I've seen dreams that move the mountains. Hope that doesn't ever end, even when the sky is falling. I've seen miracles just happen. Silent prayers get answered. Broken hearts become brand new. That's what faith can do. It doesn't matter what you've heard. Impossible is not a word. It's just a reason for someone not to try. Everybody's scared to death when they decide to take that step out on the water, but it'll be alright. Life's so much more than what your eyes are seeing. You will find your way if you keep.
So my sister shared this song with me on Facebook, the song you just heard on that video. And as I was sitting there listening to it, it was YouTube, so I didn't watch the music video because it was just a guy playing the piano and singing. And as I was sitting there listening to it, you know, I was just praying about my circumstances and stretching a little bit and thinking about life, which I've been doing a lot today. I just wanted to share the song with you guys and say, you know, it kind of, you know, touched me. So it's a great song. I'll put the link for the guy that sings the song in the bio below. But yeah, I've just been thinking, you know, and I've put Recreate Realty on the back burner one too many times. It's been in the works since 2013. It's about to be 2017. So that's 13 to 14, 14 to 15, 15, 16, 16, 17. That's almost 3.5, 4 years that I've had Recreate Realty in my mind. And now I'm finally seeing it come to fruition. And all praise be to the Lord above, because without Him, nothing's possible. And I have huge goals, as anybody that watches my videos knows. Sometimes, like, I blow myself away with the goals and dreams that I have. I'm like, Jacob, that's not possible. But it is. It is. And that's one reason that, you know, everybody's like, well, go join the oil field, or go to the coal mines, or go do pipeline. And, you know, those are great jobs. Those are great, I'm talking great jobs, great money, great benefits. But you know what? That's not really me. That's not what I want to do. And if you're watching this video right now and you're going to sit here and hate on me for not wanting to do something to better my life, well, then obviously you don't believe in me. And I'm sorry, but I'm going to take this how you want, but I'm going to prove you wrong, because the clothing line is going to happen. My dreams and my goals, whether it be the clothing line, whether it be, you know, a gym to open in the future, or any of my other goals or dreams, the haunted house, that stuff's going to happen, you guys. As long as you have a dream and you have a goal and you chase it with all your heart and all your passion every single fucking day of your life, I'm sorry to F-bomb it, but you have to. And people don't see what I do behind the scenes. People don't see the grind that I put in. They just see me on what I put on the YouTube channel, which more than likely is a majority of my life these days. And I mean, haters are going to hate. I mean, LeBron has them. Steph Curry has them. Freaking, I mean, anybody. Cristiano Ronaldo in soccer. Des Bryant in football. Everybody has haters. Like, every celebrity has haters. And I'm not doing this video for haters or anything, because I want to say thank you to the ones that do believe in me. And you guys are the ones that push me to better myself each and every day, because you're my inspiration. I've told people this numerous times, if I can bless or I can help somebody out in need, or I can be a motivator, or I can be an innovator, or I can give somebody inspiration, one person, I've done my job. And I'm not stopping at one, you guys. Like, I'm here for the long haul, and YouTube is my outlet, you guys, right now, because I don't really have a lot of, like, close-knit friends. I do, but, like, I've been by myself a lot here lately. I know, to get that off my chest, you guys, and, you know, I'm here to chase my goals, chase my dreams, and recreate my own royalty. I'm here to live my brand, you know. Since, you know, a few weeks ago when I said, hey, I'm putting down the alcohol, I've drank a couple of times, but not every single night. I haven't, you know, last night I sat at home after I got let go from Bootlegger, and I edited a YouTube video and, you know, just started thinking about, well, what's my next move? And my next move is Recreate Royalty. And all you have to do is believe and work your ass off.
All right, you guys, change of plans. So I came home and actually called my printing company. They are printing some of the shirts up. I need to go up there and pick some of them up. That's number one. Number two, we didn't make it downtown today. Just stressful day. Oh my God, don't want to deal with it. My hair is whack right now. I am about to take a shower. It is now, I have no idea what time it is, but it's around like 5:30, 6 o'clock, somewhere where it's at right now. I'm going to take a shower because this is something you guys don't know about me. It's 5:22 is what it is. This is something you guys don't know about me, and I hope I don't jinx it by doing this. So every Cowboys game this season, I wear this shirt. But it's true. It's America's team. I wear that shirt, and I normally even wear my jeans. As long as I'm wearing that shirt, and I've worn this same undershirt, just an old NutriShop t-shirt. Wear that underneath there. It matches quite well. But yeah, so I'm really superstitious about things, and I wear that shirt every game. I was going up to Bubba's 33 to watch the football games, and I don't know, I might go up there tonight. It's supposedly on NFL Network, so I really want to see the game. I'm going to watch the game. I don't care where I have to go to watch it. But it's on NFL Network, and I really want to see it. So that's just a little tidbit about myself. I'm superstitious, very superstitious. In high school, in soccer, I had a pair of lucky underwear, and I washed them after every game. It's not that they were lucky. Oh, my God, I'm not going to wash them all season. Well, the crotch area, this is getting real personal. The crotch area in the underwear, I wore them so much and sweated them so much, it like rotted out and like ripped. So I had my grandma sew a patch, like a little patch, in the bottom of the underwear. And just so I can finish out the season, we actually went the furthest pine tree my high school had ever gone in soccer. We went to the regional finals, lost by a penalty kick in overtime. I still think we got gypped, and I'm never going to blame referees for anything, but that game, we got screwed. I have the VHS to prove it. And yeah, I threw it back. That's how old I am, VHS. But yeah, so anyways, that's that. And I also put R's, like, for right, and then L's for left on the bottom of my socks. I had to put my socks on the same exact way every game. I had 3 lucky pennies that I found at our first tournament my senior year. And I found one before every single game. And every time I found a lucky penny on heads, I put it in my sock. So the first game, found a penny on heads, put it in my sock. Second game, found a penny on heads, put it in my sock. Third game, which was the semifinals, found a penny, put it in my sock. The fourth game, I didn't find a penny to put in my sock. And we lost to Coppell at their tournament. And so that's just where I guess the superstition started. So every game, I rolled those pennies in my sock my senior year. So there's a little tidbit, a little history of Jacob Wilkes for you guys. So I'm very superstitious. So tonight, rocking the Cowboys. I'll show you guys what it looks like when I get it on. It's just a t-shirt, you guys. But I'm superstitious. Got to wear it. We them boys. Got to win. So go Cowboys tonight. Anyways, I'm about to jump in the shower, and we'll see you guys when I get dressed. All right, you guys. So I got the attire on. Shirt. It's pretty much what I'm wearing. Got the America's Team on. Rocking that Nixon gold with black face watch. Got one of my favorite pairs of joggers on. I don't know what brand they are. And rocking them Nike kicks. And this is where we're going to watch the game at tonight, you guys. Here we go. So we get front row seats. That's what we're doing right here. Front row seats. Rick over here. Okay. So, yeah. This is what we got going on here. This is for Cowboys. I'm telling you, it's live for the Cowboys game.
team. We kept picking.
Well. Cowboys Nation. Man, I can't believe we won. We pulled that one out. It was a good game. Crowd was live at Bubba's. It was a fun time. And I sat there and watched the game, just chilled. We got a few, couple pizzas for free because the dude sitting at the table, like they come in here, the regulars, like Norm off Cheers. So we had a few pieces of pizza, and that's pretty much it. A few of my buddies are going to hang out for a little bit tonight, so I think I'm gonna go kick it with them for a little while. I'm probably just going home and get some rest and start my day tomorrow. So that's what we're gonna do. So this will probably be the last clip tonight. I say that, it's real dark. Oh no, it's real dark. Oh no. But yeah, so heading out and we'll see you guys on the next one. All right. We the boys. Boom. Cowboys Nation, America's team. Bam. I can fly.